Okay, there are two or three things I would like to mention. Number one is that you have to know your students really well. Students today are not the same as students 5 years ago. So, for instance, when my own teaching assistants, undergraduate teaching assistants, tell me that they don't understand the kids, then what do I think about it, right? So one of the things I keep doing all the time is just actually read lots of stuff about popular culture, about all different trends that happen, to try to understand where the students are. So a person who is 17 or 18 now, I teach lots of first year classes. I want to know how they think, what their experiences are, you know. So they think Michelangelo is a computer virus. You know, that's very different from somebody who was here 5 or 10 years ago. I just read an article where kids claim that Beethoven is the name of a dog because it comes from some movie. Okay? See, you can laugh at this, right? But the point is that that's the reality, right? So I think in many ways, so knowing whom you're talking to is extremely important at every level. I mean, we have lots of problems in math department. Many of our students opt out of our programs. And one of the major reasons is actually communication. It's actually instructors not really being aware of where the students are, what they know, what their interests are, and actually how to approach the whole teaching. We have lots of postdoc people in our department for obvious reasons. I mean, have no time to actually investigate the audience, think about these things, right? Mm-hmm. So many times we make mistakes when we teach by not knowing whom we teach. So that's one important message. And number two, I think, is you really, really have to know the stuff. See, now I'm teaching math for life sciences. In preparing for the course, I probably read 20 or 30 papers. I've read books. I've read lots and lots of things. I know math. But now I'm talking about applications, so I'm trying to learn lots and lots of things so that I'm 100% confident in the material that I'm teaching. See, many times, especially with younger people, that becomes an issue, right? So all of a sudden, there is a student who asks a question, and you're not quite sure how to answer. You know the math, but you might not know the background. So the thing that's important to is to know really what you're doing inside and out. Actually, I forgot who it was. As a prof in arts and sciences, who would actually reread all the assigned reading for her courses the summer before courses would start. You know, that's mm-hmm. what I call preparation. So you really have to prepare for your classes, right? You can't just walk in class, you know, just from the street and then expect mm-hmm. that you're going to teach well.